Say, Rex, do you truly believe that Elysium exists?
Do you even have to ask?
Don't you, Morag? I don't understand why you'd even be here then.
No, that's not what I mean. I just wanted to clarify how everyone truly feels. After all, don't most people only know of Elysium from fairy tales?
Well, I guess so, but our chum here's seen the real deal in his dreams or whatever, right?
There were wide green fields and a warm breeze and a beautiful city like nothing I've ever seen. Pyra was standing on top of a hill overlooking it all. I'm sure it must have been Elysium. There's no place like it in Orest.
The place you saw in your dream. Is it prudent to believe in Elysium based on that information alone, I wonder?
Don't you trust me and Pyra, Morag?
Oh no, I trust you both. But just because a place exists in your dreams does not necessarily mean it exists in reality. Zeke, can you honestly say you have never doubted Elysium's existence in the slightest?
Well, I guess I have wondered from time to time. At the end of the day, the only way to be truly sure is to go there, right?
True enough.
As for now, Rex believes it's real, and that's enough for me.
Aw, Zeke!
I mean, sure, it's best for everyone if it does exist, but even if it doesn't, does that really change anything? Our chum's on a mission to help Pyra reach her dream. Whatever the outcome, I want to see that through to the end.
A mission?
So what if there's no proof? Chasing after dreams is what real men are born to do.
Very well. I appreciate your passion. Though I'm not quite sure I understand your notion of a real man.
Hey, no worries. You'll figure it out eventually. I mean, you're basically the manliest one here.
Zeke, there are some things in this world you don't joke about. Even my temper has its limits. Would you like me to teach you a lesson you won't ever forget?
Morag, you're scaring me a little. Hold it, hold it. I was just joking around. Listen, nobody needs to die here, okay? Okay?